Fox 35 investigates a convicted sex predator sentenced to 6 decades in prison. Today, a judge decides he can wait for his appeal in the comfort of his own home. And the victim's family is furious.
It's kind of sick to my stomach.
The convicted sex predator could be released soon.
The news station's Valerie Boy investigates.
Convicted sex predator Matthew Tibbetts was recently sentenced to 62 years in prison for sexually battering a child. But soon he could be released and be sitting at home awaiting his appeal, all because he can afford the $1 million bond and a GPS tracker. The victim's family is disgusted.
It's kind of sick to my stomach.
It's very devastating to me and my family and my daughter.
Under Judge John Jordan's order, Tibbetts will pay for his own GPS tracker.
So to put a man with nothing to lose back out in the community, to me, that's a travesty. Frankly, GPS doesn't stop somebody.
Rafael Zaldivar agrees. His son Alex was murdered by Bestman Okafor, who was on a GPS tracker back in 2012.
GPS monitoring does nothing for public safety. It does zero. We thought we put this to rest, and now they're doing it again.
Orange County stopped using GPS trackers in 2013, calling them a liability after Zaldivar's murder. Defense attorney Whitney Boan is not involved in this case, but says if a defendant can afford to pay for a private GPS company to monitor them and the judge approves it, it's still an option.
Even though the organized court program went away for GPS in 2013, and people may not realize it, this has still been going on the entire time in terms of judges utilizing this. This judge in this case was not going rogue, you know, and doing something illegal.
But for the victim's family, it's an outrage.
It's devastating and it creates fear and anxiety. I would urge the judge to reconsider.
And the final hearing takes place on June 7th. In Orange County, Valerie Boy, Fox 35 News.